think we have to be consistent from the start, really, if you think about it. It's a 20 game schedule this year versus 27 in the past, so it's not like you can ease into the hockey schedule. So our playoffs start November 2nd, 3rd against Notre Dame, and I think just finding that level of consistency throughout the year is going to be very important for us. In particular, but we have a senior class that's exceptional, not only in leadership, but we think in talent, and they're going to have to lead kind of a younger team because we have 10 freshmen, so we feel we have the ingredients, we just have to put it all together.
There's a lot of excitement and expectations with our program to be associated with some of those teams and those rankings. They're all preseason polls, so you're a program that hopefully is somewhere in that grouping there, but it'll all come down to how we play. And our league is going to be a terrific league, and we have a great non-league.
Overall, I mean, I was more impressed that we had five teams from the league ranked in the preseason poll, the top 15 in the country. I mean, that's pretty impressive. So, essentially, we could be an NCAA tournament team and also finish fifth in your league, is what you're saying, what the poll is basically saying. But overall, I mean, you can't put a lot into those polls. I mean, the game's played on the ice. We know that. We were picked, finished last a couple years ago. And I asked the guys then, you know, not to put anything into it. So I'm not going to turn around and say this means anything. The game's played on the ice.
You know, we've learned to try to tone down the expectations based on preseason polls. So, you know, it's still a matter of what you do on the ice. We all say the same thing. It's always nice to be recognized. And, you know, I think it is a recognition of the fact that we have an older team. You know, we have 10 seniors, and those seniors all were in the Frozen Four as freshmen. So, you know, we have high expectations, but I think it's more of an internal thing than worrying about polls. You know, we have our own poll in our own mind as far as what we need to try to accomplish, and you know, we're excited about the season.
Well, Coach, this will be your third year at Northeastern, third media day here for Hockey East. Can you talk about the excitement that you're experiencing today?
Yeah, and I think at this time of year, we're all excited. We're all the college coaches, you know, the beginning of the new academic year and all our players back. And the enthusiasm, the energy level is high. And, you know, we've got 19 freshmen, sophomores, so that just perpetuates that excitement because they're ready to go. And so the last 2 weeks of preseason camp have gone really well, and our players are chomping at the bit.
With this year's class, you lost a lot of good senior leadership ability, but you're getting to step up as a captain. And with the two others that are assistant captains are also juniors. Can you talk a little bit about what that's going to be like?
It's been good so far. We got a great leadership core. The seniors that have returned, they've been great. Helping out with leadership and stuff and kind of just helping us too, letting us know that they have confidence in us to lead the team. So it's been great so far.
This is your first Hockey East media day here. What's the excitement for you?
Definitely a good buzz around here. It's exciting. The season got around the corner.
Well, Merrimack's always had a very good program. Last year you got to go to the Hockey East quarterfinals, but can you talk a little bit about what it's like going to be getting back there?
You know, it's definitely a tough road. And with, you know, the change in the schedule, only playing teams twice this year, it's going to be a bit more challenging.
So, Coach, done enough last year. What are your expectations for this year?
Well, we're obviously just looking to be better in all facets. We've had a good start at the new coaching staff, and guys getting used to a new style of play, and new personalities. But I thought they transitioned pretty quickly last year. Really, the one thing that we want to do was try to make sure that we're developing the depth of our offensive productivity. We had real good production from our top line, Mike Pereira, Brandon Graysell, and Connor Sherry. We want to make sure that we're easing the burden and making it spreading out the wealth.
Welcome to your first Hockey East media day here, Coach. What's the feeling like so far?
It's exciting, you know. I mean, it means that the season's getting closer, and we've actually been fortunate enough to be on the ice 2 hours a week the last 3 weeks. So for me, it's getting a chance to see the guys on the ice, and there's a lot of them I've never seen play before. So I mean, it always signals the start of the hockey season. Can't wait for October 5th when we actually play our first game.
Welcome to Hockey East Media Day here. Can you talk a little bit about the excitement?
Obviously we have a new coach and everything like that, so we're really excited to get going. And just every day we've been working hard. And we're really excited to start this season. I think we have a real good group of guys and should do a lot of things this year.
Well, you're a senior. Talking about the coaching change, you've gotten to play 3 years under Jack Parker, now with Quinn. Can you talk a little bit about what you're expecting?
Obviously playing for Coach Parker was great, and we'll obviously miss him, but we're really excited to work with Coach Quinn. He's taught us a lot of things just in the few weeks that we've been practicing, so we're really excited for him.
Congratulations with yesterday's pulling of ranking fourth in the nation in the USA Today poll in the preseason. Does that set any expectations for you?
I think we always have expectations across the college. We always want to be very, very successful, but we're very conscious of the fact that the preseason polls are just that. So we acknowledge, hey, that's a nice honor, but now let's start and see how good we are.
Being captain for this year, but also going forward in hockey's media. Well, you actually got to play in 38 games last year, which is pretty impressive for you athletically. Can you talk about what you had to do with the season to maintain that?
It's about doing the right things on and off the ice, just making sure you're stretching and staying healthy and keeping your nutrition up. So don't let the body break down until long season.
Coach, one of the last times you were here was a very joyous celebration with getting to put your name out there on the Hockey East banner for the championship. Can you talk a little bit about that and what it's like being back at the Garden for Hockey East Media?
Wow, it was a wonderful experience, and certainly for our players, it'll be a memorable experience for many years to come. So it's exciting. Another season is upon us, and it's an exciting time of year.
Coach of the Year, two times now consecutively. Getting to be Hockey East Championship, getting to go to the NCAA Frozen Four, can you talk a little bit about not having those expectations anymore on you? You're no longer the underdog. Yesterday you were first in the preseason. What's it like having all this kind of more notoriety and almost pressure on you?
Well, I'm not sure we treat it as such. We feel that people respect our program. That's a great thing. We're excited for our school. It's making great steps towards becoming a world-class university. And we don't treat it as expectation or pressure. We treat it as nice steps for our program and our university.